That's right. Roller coasters generally get faster throughout the day. Your experience of the same roller coaster could, and most likely will, be slightly different each time you ride. This seems a little counterintuitive. Theme parks often market their rides using speed, stating their new roller coaster reaches exactly 80 km per hour, 50 miles per hour, for example. And though the physics of the Earth doesn't change from ride to ride, there are a huge number of other minor factors that can affect how the train will perform through the circuit. So, why do roller coasters generally speed up throughout the day? Though the list of factors is long, one of the most important is temperature. Temperature has a direct impact on how fast roller coasters are able to run. To ensure the trains of the ride make it through the course, theme parks apply grease or lubricant to the wheels. This aims to reduce friction and wear between the wheel and the train's axle. The thicker the lubricant, the higher the coefficient of friction, and the quicker the wheel slows down. Temperature changes the viscosity, the thickness of the grease. The warmer the lubricant, the lower its viscosity, and therefore the lower its coefficient of friction. This means that the wheel can rotate more freely, therefore allowing the train to run faster. Interestingly, it's the temperature of the lubricant over time which has such a drastic effect on the speed of a ride. At the beginning of the day, when a roller coaster first opens to guests, the trains are cold and the lubricant has been freshly applied. This means that the viscosity and the coefficient of friction is high. As the train completes more laps around the roller coaster circuit, the lubricant begins to warm up. Over time, the grease becomes hotter and its viscosity decreases. This, in turn, reduces the coefficient of friction, allowing the trains to run faster. Because of this, the length of time a theme park is open will also affect how fast a roller coaster runs. A longer day means that the trains complete more circuits around the track, resulting in warmer lubricant, less friction, and greater speeds. As a result, some roller coasters are known to give fantastic rides at nighttime as the ride has been operating all day long. The temperature of the day can also enhance this effect too. Temperatures are often lowest in the morning, resulting in slower rides, but by the afternoon, temperatures often spike. An extremely warm sunny day could see roller coasters running excessively faster. The difference between a cold ride and one which has warmed up can sometimes be drastic. Because the trains maintain their speed throughout the circuit better, the forces experienced during the ride by guests are often increased. This means that parts of the roller coaster may feel more intense, fast-paced, and rapid later in the day. Often, roller coaster enthusiasts are cautious to make a judgment about a specific roller coaster until later in the day when it is properly warmed up. But they're right to do so. We measured this effect on Flug der Dämonen, one of the flagship roller coasters at Heide Park in Germany. By measuring the g-force experienced on the ride over time, we were able to pinpoint the exact start and ends of the layout. Shortly after opening, the ride experience was measured to last 42.6 seconds. Roughly 5 hours later, that time had reduced to just 40.5 seconds. Over multiple hours, Flug der Dämonen had gotten 2.1 seconds faster, a noticeable 5% decrease in the time it takes riders to navigate the course. Though temperature plays a big part in causing roller coasters to run faster over the course of a single day, other factors can affect the speed and duration of a ride too. In fact, those on board the train with you might determine how fast you travel through the circuit. The heavier a train is, the more momentum it has, and the longer it takes to slow down. This means that a fully loaded vehicle full of excited passengers will complete the layout faster than one with only a few riders. This effect will have more of an impact on some roller coasters compared to others though. For example, adding passengers to a small train could double its overall weight, whereas a longer train may see only a 20% increase. As a result, a fully loaded train will have more of an impact on lighter, shorter vehicles compared to heavier, longer ones. Again, a lighter train will have less momentum and will therefore be more susceptible to forces such as wind resistance. And, as we've already seen with temperature, weather can also alter the speed of a roller coaster. Depending on its direction and speed, wind can have a huge impact on how fast a ride completes the circuit. High wind speeds facing opposite to the direction of the train will push against riders, slowing them down. Though, the opposite can also be said, as a gust of wind in the right direction might help push the train along the track. In any case, many roller coasters have maximum wind speeds in which they can operate. This is done to reduce the risk of the ride slowing down too much and not making it around the entire course. Rain can also impact the speed of the trains too by serving as an additional lubricant. If the track becomes wet, the friction between the track and wheels is reduced. This allows riders to maintain their speed better throughout the course. Finally, lightning arguably has the largest impact on a roller coaster's speed. If lightning is in the area, a roller coaster will cease operation, reducing its top speed to a whopping 0 km per hour. Most of the factors discussed so far can't be precisely controlled, especially the weather conditions on the day. Theme parks do, however, have a few tricks that they can employ to make their rides faster. One of these is the type of wheel a roller coaster train uses. Steel roller coasters often use plastic wheels. Two of the most common include nylon and polyurethane. Nylon is the harder material of the two, while polyurethane is softer. Harder materials have a lower coefficient of friction, meaning roller coaster trains with nylon wheels run faster than those with polyurethane. Although, as the temperature of the wheel increases, the material becomes softer, increasing the coefficient of friction, helping to slow the trains down. Some theme parks also use a variety of wheel materials to help control the speed of the train. For example, the big one, Blackpool Pleasure Beach's tallest roller coaster, uses different wheels depending on the weather. In summer, when it's hotter, the trains usually use a softer wheel to reduce their speed, whilst in colder seasons, the train uses harder wheels to ensure the train maintains its speed at lower temperatures. Other parks might utilize a combination of harder and softer wheels to achieve the right speed too. Wooden roller coasters, on the other hand, often use steel wheels, which have an extremely low coefficient of friction against the steel running rail of the wooden track. As a result, wooden roller coasters often maintain their speed throughout the ride better than their steel counterparts. Finally, as stupid as this sounds, paint can also affect the speed of a roller coaster's train. Thick layers of paint on the ride's track can increase the friction with the train's wheels, slowing it down. Over time, the train begins to wear down the paint, causing a line to appear on the track with no paint present. Though, some amusement manufacturers have gone further, giving theme parks the option to have these worn lines on the track from the start. With a multitude of variables affecting the speed of a ride, could a roller coaster go too fast? The short answer is no. Roller coaster manufacturers take these conditions into account during the design phase to ensure rides operate safely at a range of speeds. If a train was to run too quickly, it could subject riders to uncomfortable forces or begin to degrade the components of a roller coaster faster than intended. Some rides have also been known to overshoot the brake run slightly, causing the safety systems in place to temporarily stop operation of that attraction. As a result, roller coaster manufacturers have come up with a range of methods to ensure that this doesn't happen. The most common is trim brakes, small brakes placed at specific points along the track to help moderate the speed of the train. Unlike brakes at the end of the ride, which activate by default to bring guests to a stop, trim brakes aren't always in use. Instead, they're adjustable. This means that the roller coaster's computer system is able to alter how much braking force is applied to the train. By doing this, the speed of the train can be reduced just enough to ensure it's traveling at the appropriate speed. Many rides also constantly measure the time it takes for each train to navigate the entire course. Its manufacturer will have a determined minimum and maximum time in which the ride can operate safely. If the train is traveling too fast, for example, it might complete the course quicker than this minimum time. An alert would then be sent to the ride's operators to notify them the trains are running too quickly, or it may shut down altogether as a precautionary measure. The same would also occur if a ride was running too slowly. And yes, roller coasters can run slower than designed too. As mentioned earlier, if a train is traveling around the track too slowly, it might not complete the entire course. A big gust of wind could cause it to valley, resulting in a train not making it over the next hill. This is often most likely to occur at the start of the day, where temperatures are lowest, the lubricant is cold, and the trains are empty. Fortunately, theme parks have methods to prevent this from happening. Before guests board, all theme parks cycle the trains a few times to ensure the ride is safe to operate. Whilst doing this, they sometimes fill the trains with water dummies or sandbags to mimic the weight of riders. This gives the trains more momentum, helping them to maintain their speed throughout the circuit. Once the lubricant has warmed up enough, due to successive runs, the dummies can be removed. Other parks use heaters within the station to help warm up the wheels and maintain their temperature while the train is stationary. Some wooden roller coasters even feature anti-rollback devices near parts of the ride the trains will often traverse slowly. These are large metal teeth which the train can move over forwards, but not backwards, due to their design. Therefore, if a train failed to climb the hill, instead of falling backwards, it would be caught by the anti-rollback device and remain in position. Ride maintenance staff can then push the train over the hill, allowing it to complete the remainder of the course. Ultimately, maintaining the speed of a roller coaster is a balancing act. Many factors can both help and hinder the train's speed, so parks have to be creative with their solutions. Some use different types of wheels to control the speed of the train in a variety of weather conditions, while others employ trim brakes to ensure guests aren't traveling too quickly at various points during the ride. With that being said, it's simply not possible to make a roller coaster give identical rides each time. Now, using the knowledge you've just learnt, you'll be able to cheat the system. It's quite simple. Want a fast ride on your favourite roller coaster? Wait until the end of the day. If you enjoy our content and would like to support the channel, consider checking out our Patreon page or visiting our online merch store. You'll find links to both in the description below.